Okay, let's see. So, first of all, I would like to apologize. My assistant manager was responsible for this presentation, but unfortunately is not available. So you are certainly the manager of the Avica here, but it's not the same level in English. I think you already have realizing that. And sorry for my English, so very sorry. What is Avica? Avica is an association of elected representatives that represents the entire territory, metropolitan France, and overseas. Up. Okay. So, all the local authority of France and overseas belong to Avica. So the whole France is represented by us. Our job, we are focused on wireless lines and digital infrastructure, FTTH, DSL, Wi-Fi, WiMAX. Digital education and smart cities, also IoT. Our local authority is experience sharing of resources among members, and collective actions. That's like what you do with Battle Mesh, for example. We are very small compared to operators, but I can assure you, that we count in the game. We are a very powerful anti-lobby. Why? We work with all legislators, ministries, state services, research department, equipment suppliers, operators. Julien will explain to you what is this environment. For example, yesterday I was in Matignon, France, and we often work in the Senate or in the National Assembly to orient laws. The operators have lobby too, and they are always in the Senate, always in the Assembly, the National Assembly, always speaking with deputy, always speaking with senators, and we are an anti-lobbying. We say no, if you do that, it will be worse than before, and so we are very, very present. But we are just 9 people. And so we are very small. But one other way for us, we coordinate our action with the other principal local government associations. There are a few governments, so there's an association for les régions, the towns, the department, and they are not specialized like us in digital society. We are specialized, so when they want to, sometimes when the representative voted a law, and if they don't know how, what to do, they ask us, and to explain. To orient the vote. One of our other way, we are member of all committee who exist, and there is a lot of committee who exist in the digital society in France. So it's difficult, but you have to be in this place because there are deputies, they vote, but a lot of them don't know what. About the vote, you have to vote that or that or that, and lots of the law, lots of the decret are decided here in this place. So you have to be there. So it's It needs time to be there and to make anti-lobby actions. How do the local authority invest in the digital society, in the networks? What interests you, I think, most? There is different legal models. The most known model is delegation de service public. It's all explained here. I don't want to read that. It's very boring. I will explain in a short shame after. What is it? But you just remember, concession is, I have a job, I have a public job to do, but I think a private actor can do this job best as me. But he just do for me. I don't give him all the key. I just give him the job to do, but it's still a public job. For example, les autoroutes, motorways, public transport, airports, casino, parking, and so. So there is two kinds of concessions models. I will read my what I have written. It will be better. So the local authority here interest the design, construction, supervision, maintenance, and marketing of its network to a private operator. So he do the job, but he have a contract with me. So he can do what he want. He have to do what I have wrote. So he decide how to build, how to supervising, and how to commercialize. And he sell, he commercialize, so he market the networks to ESP, like you. And the terms are read here in the contract. So he can't do what he want here too. He do what we have decided. So if there is a problem with an ISP, an associative ISP, he have to ask the operator or the local authority. And we have no contact with the final consumers. It's clear? So these kinds of contracts are long-term contracts, 20 to 35 years long. And after the end of the contracts, the networks belong to the local authority. It don't belong to the private operator. Another shame, leasing. So don't look at that. First, just look at this shame. So the local authority built designed and built the networks. And then it chose a local operator just to manage and market the network. So it's not quite the same shame because it's very difficult to do that. And so there is two ways to build. It's not very interesting. So it's les marchés publics. Comment tu dirais ça?
Public contract.
Ouais. Ok, c'est le droit de la concurrence, mais bon, c'est pas grave. So it's the same. So ISP have access to the networks with conditions we are fixing in this contract here, and no contact with the final consumers, and is because the with this shame the command because the collectivity built the networks that this is there are. This leasing models are middle-term contracts, 12 to 15 years usually. why Collectivity Act? Why Collectivity build networks, broadband networks? Private operator build networks. Why do we build networks? There are a lot of differences between private and public deployment. For example, B2B market. In France and in some other countries, there are very, very few competitors. That's a pro B2B market in France. Orange, 20% SFR, and the other just here. That's a B2B market in France. And because of this low concurrence, there is a low digital transformation. Because all the company who need telecommunication, they have no choice, and they have just packaging offers, and they can do what they want, and it's very, very expensive. So it's a very, very low digital, few competitors and low digital transformation that in the private sector. But collectivity, local authority, donc build public B2B networks. Their name is RIP1G, Réseau d'initiative publique de première génération, first G. And not all the local of G, but a lot of them build this kind of network. And not, if you see a department, for example, not the whole department is covered by B2B networks, just a few places in the department. But then, if you look with a public B2B network, most of them are more than 10 operators. And if you see on the whole France, metropolitan France, I think if you, si on additionne, we sum up all the RIP first G, I think we have perhaps 10% of orange fiber optical network. So we are very small, but we have more consumers than Orange. So we are very, very, very competitive. I say here, there is a, 52, je ne sais pas comment on dit, 52 and 50, 52 RIP who have more than 10 operators, but some of them are more than 30 and 40, c'est ça? Most of them have more than 30 different operators. And it's the same thing for the RIP2G, like FTTH RIP. So, sorry, the map was has not been updated since last year. There are RIP here, 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 then here, and here. Not the whole France is covered, but Saint-Barthélemy. Saint-Martin, it's very, it's not funny, but it's not, c'est pas étonnant, it's not surprising. The Orange said they want to build their own networks. Public networks, and you see, I think 5 years ago, and then Orange came and said, "No, I will do all with private funds, so no public funds. I will do all." So the collectivity stopped all, and then the Hurricane Emma came, destroyed all, and then Orange said, "Ah, no, too difficult." Orange say we need public funds. So, si tu pouvais traduire ce que je veux dire, c'est en fait dès qu'il y a comment on a besoin des collectivités dès qu'il y a du déficit.
Yeah. Basically, when it's not profitable, we need the public investment.
So, RIP 2G, we have a good level of concurrence. It's not the same as B2B networks, but because we don't do what we want. It's a regulated sector, and we can have the price we want, we can have the offer we want. We have to check our offers to the ARCEP. ARCEP is
the telecom
regulator. So he say you can no, it's not very, it's not enough expensive, or this is too expensive. It's a very regulated economy. But in the private sector, there is less than 4 operators. And in the public sector, and public networks, there are more ISP. That's the first difference between public and private networks. Second difference, well, in the very high density areas, just private operator can deploy FTTH. That's when in France. And they deployed since 10 years ago. So that's the numbers of the cities. Yes. Hop là, pourquoi on voit pas les chiffres? Ah, voilà. And here is the cities who are finished. For example, Paris. Paris is not finished today. It's quite finished, but it's not finished today. And it's the easiest town to deploy. Second, there is a private initiative era who's called AMI, AM2Z. I won't translate it, it's not interested. You just have to remember it's a historical private initiative era. It was decided in Machin. I have a very, very low level in English. Ich kann den auch erklären in Deutsch. Wenn manche Leute nicht sprechen Deutsch, wird es einfacher für mich. So, there are a lot of cities. Ah, sorry. I don't know why the animation. Okay. What is very typical? They have to complete all this town, but they have since this year. But they have completed very, very few towns since this last 8 years. Why? Because all the cities are very expensive to do, so they do it, but very, very, very slowly, very slowly, and. There is no contract between private operators and the public local authorities, so they do what they want. The French state said, if they don't deploy, we will tax them. So it's just a menace.
Threats,
but just a threat. French. The French government, the French authority, never are very nice with private operators. Oh, je ne sais pas ce que j'ai les chiffres. Je suis désolé pour les chiffres qui apparaissent. Normalement, il y a une animation qui se fait dans le bon sens. Je ne sais pas pourquoi elle ne se fait pas. Peu importe. Since the historical private initiative area, the French government decided to rise up the number of the cities. So that's the new cities. The operators said, we want to do that. So you local authorities, you don't do this these new cities. We will do them, but they have do just three since it's began. And malgré despite this just these three cities, French national government said you can do more this year. It was today. It was last month, and we think the French operator we will do more cities. We will get more cities in next month. What they want to do is just freeze territory, just freeze for no public investment, not for no public networks. Because if they freeze, there is no concurrencies, no competitors. They do what they want, and they just capture the flag for another image. And if you do what we do in a public initiative area, so we completed what we deployed. It's not quite equal, sure, but if you see what the difference, and we began later. We began in 2013. Thanks, Baptiste. So when we began at a city, we ended the deployment of the city. Even if it's very expensive, even if it's farms who are very far away from the center of the town or the city, even if, for example, in the city, in the private sector area, there are a lot of companies. And you saw before there is low competitors in the private sector area, and what do the operators? If you have a street, they deserve all les logements, les habitations,
all houses.
And if there is a company, they jump the company. They don't deserve it, and it's a way to close the market and to avoid that other competitors come on the FTTH access and deserve the company. We deploy all, and. If you see the difference, it's just because we need sometimes 2 or 3 years to deserve some town because it's very expensive. It's very more expensive. We said when a private operator built one FTTH access in the private area for the same price, the same engineering, the same investment, when we built in the public sector area one FTTH access for the same price, the private operators built 3 access. It's clear?
Because it's denser areas with more people, denser, it's cheaper to the private.
At last, I will just short explain. I think it's more, it doesn't interest all of you, but I will explain just a difference in the mobile phone coverage visions between the French government and us. When you ask the local authorities, do you have a problem with the mobile phone coverage? They answer in an in a software in a, on an internet service, the answer, and they said, so it's a map. When it's red, it's a place where local authority, so mayors, deputy, senators, said we have a problem. So there are a lot of problems here, and there are a lot of problems here, a lot of problems here. Okay, that's what people say, what people ressentir, feeling. But when we ask the French state to, when we present this map, the French government said, oh, but that's not what the operator said. The operator said that. Well, you have to, here they need new base station. So there is a new base station here. So for example, just Brittany. If you see, more problems are here, and the operator say it's here where we need more base station. And you can see, you can compare, it's always the same. So our job for Avica, I think when I say we are an anti-lobby, that's what the French government decide to do. They decide to build new base station where the private operator said. And our job is to ever to contest what the private operator said, and to challenge and to change. It's very difficult, but to change the French government approach of l'aménagement numérique, digital infrastructure, digital planning. So, one more time, sorry for my English. And thank you very much. Thank you.